Welcome back to a brand new coffee tech break with Jan. Today, I want to take you through brand new version for Studio X and G7500, and that is version 3.9. Now, hopefully you enjoyed my last videos where I also took you through the Sync family, great speakerphone, not only at the office, but also at home. You can even pair them up to have a sort of stereo sound in your room. I also showed you the Lens app, etc. Now, today, as I said, I got a great video for you lined up about Studio X G7500 version 3.9. And I think a really exciting release because we got now the availability in Teams mode of the HDMI ingest and the device mode, the bring your own device mode. So walk into the room with your laptop, have the ability to share using your HDMI cable or use your laptop as a video client with Zoom, Starleaf, or Ring Central, or any video app that you have on your laptop, and have the ability to reuse camera, speaker, and mic in the studio is, I think, some great new use cases which we have available now. As usual, I will jump in my laptop and walk you through this presentation with all those great new features. And I will jump out at some points to show you how it looks like, the different use cases, how the interface looks like, etc. So hopefully you enjoyed it. As usual, if you like this type of video, just subscribe to my channel and always keep you updated. Also, in new year 2022, and stay tuned because there's a lot of exciting features and functions coming up. So stay tuned to my channel, and I always keep you updated with the latest and greatest. Now let's jump in my laptop and show you those exciting new features in the 3.9. Now, as usual, just sit back, relax, take a cup of coffee, and I will run you through this presentation. Of course, today we are in a sort of Christmas mood because it's almost Christmas, so it's a sort of surprise also for a lot of people, and hopefully a lot of good news here to share with you. Version 3.9, I think a really exciting release. Now, as usual, all the apps are updated, but I will talk you to those biggest updates that there are. And I will always recommend to check out the release notes. So in the comments, I will also put a link to the release notes. You will be able to find them quickly and get to all those details. As I said, applications are updated. There are some features in the Studio X, which I will share. So really, really exciting release. Now, let's get to it. First off, before I start, always the baseline upgrade and downgrade, because I think this is really critical. Now, you can use the local web interface for your upgrade and downgrade. So the device always gets an IP address as soon as it's hooked up to the network, and you're able to connect to that web interface and initiate those updates. Now, what is important? Before you update, check if you got automatic updates enabled or only during maintenance hours. But if you do this, make sure next day you come at the location, you first check the meeting rooms, if everything is up and running. I always recommend to turn this off and just do one or two rooms, just first test them out to make sure that those rooms are working properly. And as you can see here, we got the 3.9 available through that web interface. Now, the other way to upgrade your devices in case you don't have internet connectivity is using the USB stick. So make sure you got a proper USB stick with enough space that you can put on the image there. You just put it in the Studio X and you're able to update the device. Now, what is important is that you unpack that whole upgrade package on the stick. So you got it available there, and the Studio X is able to read the stick. I created also some other videos where you're able to check that out. Now, another method is PolyLens. So in case you're using PolyLens And it could be for some specific settings on your devices, like if you want to change the speaker track to group track, or you want to use certificates or everything. I can imagine that you use PolyLens, that will be able to add value to that. That's free to use. And from PolyLens, the nice thing is you can select specific versions. So not only an upgrade, but you also can do a downgrade. Now, what is always important with those upgrades is that you also make sure that the TC8 is paired. And the TC8 is the controller, the table, which needs to be in sync with the version you got running on that Studio X. And that's very, very important. And in Lens, you have the ability to create groups, specific groups where you can first test out that version 3.9 to see if everything is working as expected for your meeting rooms before you do further rollouts of that version. Now, of course, there's also upgrades available in Teams Admin Center, and also make sure you update both of these devices. In Teams Admin Center, the same procedure. You got the specific tab for Studio X, and you got that other tab, controller tab, specifically for the TC8. Similar for Zoom. So if you got it also in Zoom and your Studio X, you have the availability to also push out software updates from there. Really, really nice. This is always important as the baseline. So I'll use this always as a guidance before start using that upgraded devices. And as I said, always test the devices in your meeting rooms to make sure that everything is working as expected before you roll out any other rooms. Upgrades and downgrades. Now, what is in version 3.9? And so version 3.9 comes back with TC8 version 3.9. So as I said, if you kind of push this out, make sure that your TC8 is always paired. So it also get that update to make sure that the Studio X and the TC8 are in sync. Now, specifically on the E70. So the E70 gets software updates through the G7500. That is an option. And now, in case you use MTR for Windows, make sure you install that Lens application. And not only for the Studio E70, but also if you got the Sync 60 or Sync 40 with your MTR for Windows, the Lens app will be available to push out software updates, change speaker track, to group track, etc. Now, I will put in the comments, I will put a link where you can find the Lens app very, very quickly. Just as a reminder for the Studio E70. Now, what is further enhanced in the 3.9 release? We got some great Telnet enhancements for the AV integrators. For example, to turn near tracking on and off. We have that available now through the Telnet, through the APIs. Also, the availability to set and get the provider. So in case you want to change the device into another provider, for example, you are in Teams and you need it for a day in Zoom, then you have here the availability to change that. The system will reboot, but you will not lose any settings. You're able to change that using this command. For example, if you got Crestron or AMX, you got now the availability to use those external controls to change the provider. And also the ability to start and stop HDMI content. That is also now added. Now, I have the API guide, which again, I will put in the comments. So you got a quick link there to all those commands. Now here specifically on the new provider commands, as you will see, it's very easy laid out in the API guide. So you have the availability here to just change it by using the provider mode set command, put in the provider in which mode you want to use the device, and you're able to change it. Now, what more has been enhanced in the 3.9? That's the speaker tracking. So speaker tracking, with every new release, we have enhancements in speaker tracking and group tracking, presenter tracking. So in this version, there's specifically been some tracking enhancements with people who are wearing masks, but also for people who are visible from the side, to make sure when somebody speaks from the side, these are visible. And also with whiteboarding, so people just facing away from the camera, we also need to make sure that these are visible. Now, looking at the applications, always a really exciting moment for us. I'm always trying to pick out those biggest items. I mean, all those video providers usually have updates. As soon as you hook it up, you sign into that application, and you will get usually those updates. And I'm trying to pick out those really interesting updates that we have in the 3.9. And I think one that is really one where a lot of people are waiting for is an update from the MTR for Android with the availability of some two big items, which I'm going to show you right here. Now, first off, which version is in that 3.9? As you can see, you can find that version right here. I always recommend there's always some calling, user experience and video optimization in those APKs, those Teams app updates. So I always recommend to update to the latest versions, but do that first in a couple of rooms. Just test it out a couple of days and make sure that everything is working properly in your specific environment. Now, that is the version that comes along with 3.9. So you should be able to find this same update. Might take some time, might jump into the new year, but you should be able to find this update also through Teams Admin Center. And always recommend that if you're gonna update it from Teams Admin Center, make sure you update the Studio X and also update your Touch Console. So this is important that all of those devices are always in sync when you update them. Here it comes. What do we have available now in the Studio X, the MTR for Android? And here you go. It is the HDMI ingest and the device mode. And I used to call it automatic device mode, because if you hook up your laptop, it will automatically jump into device mode, which I think is really nice for the total user experience. Now, that means that you can now, if you are using your Studio X 50, X30 or G7500 in a sort of a Teams preview, if you use those devices in Teams and you hook it up to the laptop, you can use on your laptop any video client. That doesn't matter. It will be seen as USB peripherals. So camera, speaker and mic, you're able to reuse that. Just put in the HDMI cable. You want to share the screen from your laptop on the device. And on the other side, you got that USB cable coming out of the X3050 or G7500, put it in the laptop and you're able to reuse it. It's available in the 3.9 release, so you're able to test that out. Now, there is an important item which you need to take a look at, because it is in the preview ring. So Microsoft has a couple of rings, which are a development ring, which is a preview ring, and at the end it becomes in the public ring. Now, I know that it will move into the public ring very soon. So it could already be that you see the HDMI ingest or BYOD mode, that you see it already there. If you don't see it, it could be that you are not in this preview ring. So it should pop up at some point of time. And also, there are users, if you got that room account or a user account, this also needs to be in that preview ring. This is not something configurable from your Teams Admin Center as you configure this. No, this is really something you need to set and enable by Microsoft. So go through Microsoft support and you can check there if you are already in this, if you are in this preview ring or if you are in this public ring. But anyway, it should come up or pop up in the new year. I would say, just in case, reboot your device. You can try to sign out and sign in again. I've seen that also, that then suddenly the HDMI ingest became available. So there are some things you can test. So this is why I really recommend just to test it out in your environment, in your lab, and see and test that with one or two devices. and see if that HDMI ingest becomes available. But it is there now. So it is, I think, really exciting because I know a lot of customers and partners were waiting for it and to have that available. Now, let me show you the use cases. Eh? So what is that user experience? And also I will show it here on my laptop. And so you got a little bit of a impression how that looks like in practical. But here you see it in PowerPoint. And so how does it look like? First off, you're gonna put in the HDMI cable. Important, it is a video only in this application. So be aware of that. It's not a limitation in the Studio X, but the Teams app running on Studio X doesn't do audio today. And so that is very important. In any other mode, so if you can use it, the Studio X in Zoom or in PolyOS or any other application, and then you should be able to parse audio. So be aware of that with the Teams application, it is video only. Now, if you got a presentation and you're not in a Teams session, just walking into that room and you want to share that, you put in the HDMI cable, this will pop up on the screen. Very nasty, very basic, very easy. And as I said, I will show you that in a bit also how it looks like. But this is really straightforward. Now, the next option, which is actually option one, is you plug in that USB cable. So you want to use your laptop, you walk into that room. I got, for example, a Zoom session, or RingCentral, or a Starleaf session, or a Log Me In session, or any of those other video applications running on your laptop. You put in the USB cable, and now the system will automatically jump in that device mode. Very, very nice. So it is like for a user and for the workflow, it is very friendly. You just walk in and you got that available. That is option one. If you unplug the USB cable, you can set a timer. So I will put a link right there where you're able to find that video because it's a configurable timer. You could say if I unplug the USB cable, you go directly back to Teams, or if you unplug it, you want to wait for like 30 seconds, 60 seconds, 1 minute, 2 minutes. You got a configurable timer there. So you can configure that when the moment is, say you want to switch back to that native application. And now that is option one. Option two is using that side menu in the TC8. So I will show you that. So you can use that side menu, which is available here, and you're able to jump into the device. But that's the other option where you can do that manually. But as usual, and what people always appreciate, let me jump out of the laptop now and show you this in practical. So I got here on the Studio X30, I got 3.9 running. Similar with the TC8, you got 3.9 running with that latest app. Now, I got here a laptop with the ability to share content. Also, I have here the HDMI in cable, which is going to that X30. And I got the USB cable right here, ready with the ability to share camera, speaker and mic, the device mode with the X30. Now, let me show you where those cables are going to on the hardware. So here you see an X30. Here you see the HDMI input, which is also on the X50 and the G3500. And here you see that USB-C cable, which is to share camera, speaker and mic with the laptop. And at the end comes at the table as a USB-A cable. Now, this scenario, I think very easy. I got here my laptop and I just want to have the ability to share something on the screen. So I'm grabbing here that HDMI cable, just put it in the laptop, just pretty straightforward. But that was something that was not available before, using it in native Teams. And here you go. You have the availability now of that content. And also you can go up and down and the responsiveness is very good. So there's always some bit of delay, but to share a presentation or anything, it is very, very much usable. Now, on the other end, what if I want to stop sharing? So you will see on the patch panel, you will see the option, if I click on more, you will see the option here to stop sharing. So I can always stop sharing if you want to first do something on your laptop. Without sharing, you can do that. And if I press share again, what you will see, it will show up on the screen because the laptop is still connected. That is one scenario. So just in a room, when you want to have the availability to share content, very easily, you just put in that HDMI cable and you can do that. Now, the other scenario is using that USB cable, that BYOD scenario. Similar thing, we grab that USB cable and look what will happen to the Studio X30. What you will see right here, it jumps into the device mode. Here you go. So completely automatically, it jumps into that mode. And what you will see now, if I, for example, grab my Zoom client right here, and let me go here to the settings. Let me try to show you that. If I now go here to video, here you go. And you see, I got that X30 now mentioning right there, Poly Studio X30. And now if I go to audio, similar, what you will see, you see also the mic getting audio. You see here as a speaker, X30, and here as a mic, X30. So I can use it now in Zoom, camera, speaker, and mic, and reuse that with this device. Really, really nice. It detects it automatically, just plugging in the USB cable. There's no specific drivers or anything like that. Just plug in the USB cable, and you're able to reuse it. Now, other scenario is sharing your screen. So when you are in device mode, I can also grab that HDMI cable, put it into my laptop, and now I'm both using camera, speaker, and mic, but you also have the availability now to share your screen. So while you're in a Zoom meeting, you have the availability now to just share your screen also at the same time. So you can really reuse the complete device, X30, X50, and the G7500, and use that from my laptop here on the screen. I think a really nice use case available now with version 3.9. Now, here it comes. As soon as you unplug it, you can set a predefined timer to jump back. Now, I set it to immediately. So let me plug it out, and what you will see is now the device, the X30, will jump immediately back into that native Teams mode. Now, the second option which I wanted to show you to jump in the device mode is on the TC8. So here you got TC8, and remember this side menu. Now, there was not only the camera control, and so you have the availability there for camera control to turn, for example, the tracking on and off, as you can see. So you can turn the tracking. You got also manual camera control. So here we'll jump into presets, and you can manual do a PTC there or set tracking on and off. Really nice. That was already available. But as you can see, we have also the device mode there now. So if you want to start the device mode there, it's just a matter of you click on it, and this will also jump into device mode. And there's the mute button, you got volume control, and you can exit the device mode also here from the TC8. Or in case you got a touchscreen, you can do that also, of course, from the touchscreen. That was the second option to jump into the device mode. That was concerning HDMI sharing and device mode in combination with Teams. I think really excited. Now, look at some of those AV integration options. So in the basis, you will need to have that USB cable and that HDMI cable to the table. Now, there are options, third-party USB hubs, where you're able to combine that. Now, these hubs, which I think is very important, will usually depend also on the laptop that you are using. So you could bring in the back of the X30, you could bring the HDMI cable and that USB cable together here into that hub. And then you got one cable that is usually a USB-C cable going to the laptop, which has the ability to transfer camera, speaker, and mic, and also the screen sharing. But as I said, it is usually would require a specific driver on the laptop. But that is an option. I would say always discuss this with your AV partner where you work with and test this out. Now, of course, to extend cables or convert to cut, there's a lot of options out there. So we got longer USB cables. So if you need longer USB cables, that is always an option. These are more fiber USB cables, but you cannot easily integrate that. So if you want to transfer that USB to cut, and as I showed you also in that previous video, you can use Sound Control or Icon Raven and make sure you can build those cables into any room. But be aware that I always recommend to discuss this also with your AV partner, which usually has a lot of experience with changing those cables and do that AV integration. Now, next thing is the G7500 is in Teams preview mode. Very nice. So we have this in preview mode available. So you can start testing it, play around with it. And what is important is that it's specifically supported with the HDCI cameras. So you must have one of those cameras, Eagle Director 2, Producer, Eagle Eye 4, the 4x zoom, 12x zoom. You can start testing and play around with that. Of course, you will also have the BYOD mode available now. You also got the HDMI ingest available now, and you can start testing with that. And if you got any other equipment there, you could reuse by IP adapter. You could use the ceiling mics, for example, from Group Series, or you could reuse table mics from Group Series, but that would require that IP adapter connected to the G7500. Really nice. So this is in the Teams preview mode. Further up, what do we have? There's a lot of things going on, as you can see. Now, we got also Zoom. Looking at Zoom, what's happening right there? At Zoom, we also got some updates. So with that 3.9, we got Zoom App 5A3, which is right in there. So you can start using that and integrate that. Now, it could be that Zoom has already a newer version in their Zoom portal. And that is a possibility, similar like with Teams. Now, you always can push out newer version if needed. So always check in the Zoom admin portal if you find some newer versions there. That is a possibility. Now, what is available and what is new in that latest Zoom application? We got now officially support for that Smart Gallery Multiview with the E70 and the G7500. And also the support for the X70 doing that Smart Gallery and Multiview. Really excited. So you're able to capture participants in the room and show them into the gallery view of Zoom. Expect some videos in the new year showing this live in our experience center and give you some impressions of that. It's a really nice feature of Zoom and now supported also with the E70, G7500, and as I said, with the X70. Really excited. What more do we have? We got the BlueJeans applications, which is officially now out of the beta. So this is now public available in the Studio X series, Studio X or the G7500. Now, lastly, what I want to mention, always check the release notes. I will put a link in the comments so you're able to check them out. There you can find a list of all the new features available, but also in that release notes, you can find which feature, which application is supported in what device or what video application. And so always take a look at there for the specifics, very important. Now, this concludes my video on the 3.9. Hopefully you enjoyed it. I would say for now, I wanted to wish you a Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year. If you like this type of video, I would say subscribe to my channel. And in the new year, we got a lot of new things going on, looking at products, looking at features, new versions. If you subscribe to my channel, I will always keep you updated when some new features come out.